गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 10, कम बैक टुडे विद द सॉल्यूशन ऑफ वर्कशीट ऑफ फर्स्ट यूनिट टेस्ट. क्लियर? नाउ फर्स्ट आई विल बी स्टार्टिंग विद एरिथमेटिक पार्ट. देयर इज सिंपल इंटरेस्ट एंड कंपाउंड इंटरेस्ट. टुडे आई विल बी सॉल्विंग ऑफ सिंपल इंटरेस्ट चैप्टर. फर्स्ट एमसीक्यू पार्ट, सिंपल इंटरेस्ट एमसीक्यू पार्ट. ओके, सम नंबर वन, आ प्रिंसिपल बिकम्स डबल इन 20 ईयर्स ऑफ अ फिक्स्ड रेट ऑफ एसआई. द प्रिंसिपल विल बी 3 टाइम्स एट द सेम रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट इन, यू हैव टू, ऑप्शंस आर गिवन ऑफ ईयर्स. ओके, इन फर्स्ट व्हाट दे हैव टोल्ड, अ प्रिंसिपल बिकम्स डबल, दैट मीन्स अमाउंट, इफ प्रिंसिपल बी पी, अमाउंट विल बी ट्वाइस ऑफ पी, एंड टाइम गिवन 20 ईयर्स, एंड rate not given, RI not given. Okay, and at the same rate, second case, the principal will be 3 times at the same rate of interest. Okay, first case here, let principal be rupees P, therefore amount is told becomes double, amount is twice of P. So what will be the interest? Interest is amount minus principal, so it is coming rupees P. Amount is coming rupees P, and time is given 20 years. Time 20 years. And rate, we consider late rate be R. R person per annum. Clear? So, you know what formula you have to apply here? Simple interest. I equals to PRT by 100. So, I equals to PRT by 100. Now, I means P. P equals to wait. P equals to, here also P, R not given, T given 20 by 100. So from here, what we are getting? We are getting rate. R we are getting 5%. Clear? So from first case, we have got R. It was not given. Now in second case, it is told that the principal will be 3 times at the same rate in which year? In how many years? Okay, principal will be 3 times. So, principal P already we have considered, and amount is coming 3 times. Clear? So, what will be your interest? Amount minus principal. In this case, your interest is coming rupees 2P. Now, here, interest we know, principal is P, R we know, here you have to consider T in second case. So again same formula, in simple interest you know only there are 2 formulas, I equals to PRT by 100 and amount equals to principal plus interest. So second case, I equals to PRT by 100, here I means 2P. Interest is 2P, principal is P, R is 5%, T is unknown. P, P cancel out, therefore T is coming 20 into 2, 40 years. Here your option is number 3. Third option is correct. T equals to 40 years. Then, second one. In how many years will the ratio of simple interest and principal sum of money be 3:2 at 10% interest per annum? Here, what is given in sum number 2? Ratio of SI and PE principal given 3:2 and rate of interest given. Here, you have to calculate T, time period. Okay. Now, in number B, in how many years will the ratio? Okay, ratio of simple interest and principal given 3:2. So you know when ratio will be given, we will consider let simple interest be rupees 3x and principal will be rupees 2x, where x is common multiple. And rate of interest given 10%. Clear? So same formula, T is unknown, I equals to P R T by 100. I is what? I is simple interest 3x. 3x equals to principal is 2x, R is 10, time is unknown by 100. So time period T is coming, 5 are 15 years. 15 years, option 3. Clear? Option 3. Next one. Number C. If the amount of a principal at the rate of 4% per year, means per annum, for X years is rupees Y. Clear? Here amount given rupees Y. And then the principal will be. Principal not given. So we may consider let the principal be rupees P. And years given X and rate of interest given 4%. So what informations are there? Firstly, write down. Amount is given rupees Y. And time is given X years. Clear? And rate is given 4% per annum. Per year means annum means year. Per annum. Okay? Then the principal will be. We consider let the principal be P. Let the principal be rupees P. So one same formula, I equals to P R T by 100. Here interest, what to calculate is the amount of the principal for X is amount is this. Okay, from here you have to calculate interest. Amount Y, amount equals to principal plus interest. Principal is P, so what is your interest? Y minus P. Clear? So here we'll put Y minus P, amount minus principal equals to interest. P R is 4, time is X by 100. Now it is given in form of 100, so will not cancel. Okay. Then P will take one side as we have to calculate the principal. So P we are taking in one side. So P plus 4PX by 100. From here you take P common, then it is becoming 1 plus 4X by 100. Then take the LCM,
y equals to p into p into 100 plus 4x by 100 after taking LCM. Therefore, P is coming after cross multiplication. 100y by 100 plus 4x. Option number 100y by 100 plus 4x. Option 3. Clear? So here what we have done? We have considered, let the principal be P, amount given Y, and from here we had calculated interest. Interest is amount minus principal. Then in this relation or in this formula, I equals to P at T by 100, we have put this interest as Y minus P, and this is as usual by putting the values of R and T, and then P we had taken in right hand side, we had taken P common, then P equals to this. Then next one. Number D. If the total interest becomes rupees PXR by 25 for any principal having the rate of SI of R% percent per annum for X years, then the principal will be this. Okay, total interest. So what informations are there? Writing interest equals to rupees PXR by 25 and rate given R% percent and year, time period given X years. Clear? Then the principal will be this. Here we as an interest this is given, so we will consider let the principal be Y. Okay, don't take principal as P, so it for calculation it will be problem. So here we will consider let the principal be Y, except X and R and P, any other variable we can consider. So here we are considering let the principal be rupees Y. So interest equals to P R T by 100. Interest is this PXR by 25 equals to principal we have considered as Y and R as RD given and P given X by 100. So XX will be cancelled out, R will be cancelled out, 25 and 100, 4. So Y is coming 4. P. Y means our principal. So principal is coming rupees 4P. Option number 4. Clear? Then next one. Number E. If the ratio of principal and interest is 24:1, then the rate of interest will be this. Ratio of principal and interest, okay. Principal is to interest given 24:1. Again, ratio given, so we consider let the principal be rupees 24x and interest rupees x, where x is common multiple. Clear? Then rate of interest will be this. Okay, here rate of interest means we have to consider time period as 1. Clear? Rate of interest we have to calculate, so time period will be 1. It is not mentioned, but you have to understand rate of interest is, so time period is 1 here. So I equals to PRT by 100. Our interest is x and principal is 24x. Rate of interest are not given, t is 1 year by 100. So x, x you cancel. So here by 4 we can cancel, 4, 6 and 4, 25. So R is coming 25 by 6. So it is coming 4 whole 1 by 6%. Rate is coming 4 whole 1 by 6%. Option 4. Clear? So this was ABCDE MCQ part. Now I'll be starting with short answer. Short answer number A. Find the amount of rupees 40,000 from 15th January 2004 to 9th June 2004 at 13% per annum. Okay, here principal given rupees 40,000. Clear? And time afterwards we'll calculate rate given 13% per annum. One thing here, you have to find out the year. Date given 15 January 2004 to 9th June 2004. So first you have to calculate whether that this year 2004 is leap year or not. 2004, how you can find out it is a leap year or not? 2004 will be divided by 4. Now if I divide, then you see it is coming, no remainder is coming, it is completely divided by 4. So in the month of February there will be 29 days in leap year, and if it is not leap year, then it will be 28 days. Clear? Now we have to calculate the total number of days. So first January, February, March, April, May, June. Clear? 15th January. So 31 days, 31 minus 15 equal to 16, plus February 29 days, plus January, February, March. March 31, January, February, March, April. April 30, May 31, and June it is told that 9th June. So if we add, it will come 146 days. It is coming 146 days. Clear? Now 146 days we'll convert it to year. So 146 by 365 year. So by 73 it will be cancelled out only. Okay, so by 73 2 and here 5. So it is coming, t is coming 2 by 5 here. And rate is this, principal is this. Then we will calculate our interest. Therefore, interest equals to TRT by 100. Interest, the principal is given rupees 40,000. And rate was 13. T is 2 by 5. Then Okay. 2080. After multiplication, it is coming rupees 2080. This is my interest. But what to calculate? You have to calculate amount. Therefore, amount equals to principal plus interest. Principal was 40,000 and interest is coming this. So, 0802. So our amount is coming 42,080. This is your answer. So first, what we had done from 15 Jan to 9th June, we had calculated the total number of days. Then we had converted this number of days to year. Clear? Then rate given, principal given. Time we had calculated, then in this formula I equals to PRT by 100, we have put all the values and then we had calculated first interest. Then after getting the interest, we are getting amount equals to principal plus interest. So if you add, you will get this amount. Clear? Now next part you will get in next video.